وسم كل شيء ما عداه بالفناء والعدم، كما قال عز شأنه: كل شيء هالك إلا وجهه، وكل نفس ذائقة الموت، وقال: كل من عليها فان، ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنام، سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا أبي القاسم محمد. وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين، ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين. من الآن إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، فقد قال الله في كتابه الكريم: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى. صلوات. In continuation to our topic that we are discussing from Risalatul Huquq of Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam, the right of the person by whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes you happy. So when you receive any happiness from someone, from the time that he started any favor to you, he has a right that you have to pay. So Imam has discussed those rights, rights of the person who becomes the medium of help and support and happiness for you. Why? Because the original help comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and anybody who is in between, he is just a medium, someone who has helped you by the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah keeps in the mind of and heart of someone to come and help you for anything in your life. But this person also has the right on you. Don't say, okay, he has no right on me. Why? Because Allah is the real helper. As we discussed earlier, there is an ideology in Islamic sects. Some people think that the mediums have no importance. When help is coming from Allah directly, so we have to just say thank you to Allah only. And the people who are in between have no right on us. Or if they have right on us, we should not be as thankful to them as sometimes, according to them, it becomes shirk to them. It becomes kufr for them if you be thankful to someone else other than Allah. But this is not right. It is against the teachings of Quran. It is against the teachings of Islam. And Islam says that those who become the medium and the means for the blessings of Allah for you, those people also have great right on you. Otherwise, Quran would not have emphasized on the rights of the parents. And as we discussed earlier, that the rights of Anbiya and Awliya, those guides appointed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the same. Or they have the most right on us. Why? Because a prophet who is a messenger of Allah, who brought us the message of Islam, he has the right more than anyone else in this world on us. So anyone who becomes the medium, he has a right. This is the bottom line, what Imam is saying. أَمَّا حَقُّ مَنْ سَرَّكَ بِهِ اللَّهُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ. But of course, this is true, that origin of that help and support and happiness coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فإن كان تعمدها, if he had helped you purposely, knowingly, voluntarily, حمدت الله أولا. Yes. Now here are the manners of paying shukr to somebody else, anyone, a human being. And this is the delicate point that those who misunderstand Quranic ayat, they didn't understand this delicate point. When they say that if you be thankful to someone other than Allah, they say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, all praise due to Allah. When all praise due to Allah, so don't praise anybody else. If you praise someone else, this becomes kind of shirk. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, O Allah, we worship you only and we seek help from you only. So don't seek help from anybody else. Otherwise, it becomes shirk. But this is not practical, and this is against the nature, not just against Islam. And Islam is the religion of nature, as you know. So the main point is here. Imam is teaching us how to refrain from shirk and be thankful to someone else who is not Allah, other than Allah. How? Anybody who helps you, who gives you any favor, don't you say thank you? Is saying thank you shirk? It's so ridiculous if you think this way. This is against Islamic teachings, brothers and sisters. Islam says no. مَنْ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ الْخَلْقِ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ الْخَالِقِ. Someone who is not thankful to the creation, he cannot be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Imam says, if you know that someone who has helped you, who has caused any happiness for you, حمدت الله. First of all, if he had done it purposely, or he was not intending to help you, and suddenly the help came to you, you were so lucky that you, received some help from someone, that the person who helped you, he didn't intend to help you originally, but you received it. These are two scenarios. In first situation, when he is determined, he was determined to help you. He intended, purposely to help you. So what you do? Say thank you. Any help, even if he is taking compensation for that, for example, a doctor. Don't you say thank you to doctor? If he is helping you, he or she has been nice to you, and of course, they gave you the bill for that. They charge you for their help. But still, what you say? Thank you. This is the manners. This is the akhlaq, Islamic akhlaq. But Imam says that حمدت الله أولا. First, you should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for any help you receive from anybody. This is the main issue that others don't understand. There is no balance. The problem is in extremism, you don't find balance. Lack of balance is originally extremism. Islam has no extremism at all. Islam is a balanced religion. Some people say, no, just thank him only. He has nothing to do with Allah. He's a doctor. He gave you some medicine and you sought help from him. Where is Allah here? Some others say, no, it's only Allah. Only say thank you Allah, and doctor has nothing to do with that. Both are wrong. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala originally who caused this help for us through this doctor. So what should we do? حمدت الله أولا. You should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. There are so many people who then don't have access to medical help. Many people in the world have no medicine, have no doctors around, have no hospitals, no place. If you have this opportunity, Allah forbid, if you become sick and you sought help of a doctor and you received the help of a doctor, so you should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this first. ثُمَّ شَكَرْتَ وَعَلَى ذَلِكَ Then you thank him who was the medium. Of course, Allah helps, but he makes, you know, Allah has made a system of cause and effect in this world. So any help that you receive in any situation that you are in, it comes from Allah, but Allah makes it happen through something or someone. Allah does not make apparent miracles for you. No. The way you receive the help, yes, it by itself becomes miracle. But not supernatural way. It's all natural way. Allah makes it happen in natural way. When you do the dua, if you don't have a job, and you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you find a job, Allah will help you. Allah will give you the job. But of course, He will put this idea in somebody's mind or heart who will come to you and say, oh, you need a job? I have an opportunity for you. Come, I will help you find a job. And he will, of course, give you a good job. So the person is a medium. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do not ask him directly. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you receive the help from him. So this is the system that Allah has created. You cannot go to one extreme and say, no, only Allah, and don't say only this person. Allah is the origin of goodness, and this person is lucky enough to be the medium for the help. As we mentioned that many times from the ahadith of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam, that when you, if you are able to help someone, if you are helping somebody, not seeking help, rather you are helping, this helping also is a blessing for you, yourself. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you able to help someone. Why somebody is coming to you? Some people get frustrated by people who come to them for help. And the hadith of Ma'soom, it says that the more blessings you receive, the more people will come to you for help. So if more people are coming, you said, okay, only one person called me today for a help. Today 10 people called me. Oh my God, how many people are calling me? How can I answer everybody? You should say, thank you, Allah. Why 10 people calling me? It means yesterday, one. Last year, only one guy called me. This time, 10 people. It means I have 10 times blessings more this time. So the more people coming to you for help, it means more blessing you have from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't get upset. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. So this is what. Now, to keep it balanced, Imam said, first, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything you receive good that you like in your life. No matter who is the reason for that, apparent reason. Original cause is Allah. So, hamadta Allah. Be thankful to Allah. Allah, thank you very much. I got this doctor. Thank you very much. I got this friend. I got this boss, I got this company, I got this job, I got this, thank you Allah. Then you thank those people who helped you receive this blessing. Because Allah caused them to do it. This is shukr, this is about being thankful. But you know, Islam is a practical religion. Islam is not a religion of slogans and verbal claims only. I'm a mu'min, I'm a Muslim. Yes, good. Alhamdulillah, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for being a Muslim. that how you be thankful to Allah practically. Practical thank. This is what Imam is talking about. And it is so beautiful. So first shakartahu, somebody who helped you, first you thank Allah, then thank him. Then he says, وَكَافَأْتَهُ فِي فَضْلِ الْإِبْتِدَاءِ. Something very amazing, look. And we believe that the sayings of Ma'asumin are very much in, in line with the Quranic teachings. Or you can put it in this way. We say, whatever Ahlul Bayt say, it is the explanation of Quran. So Quran has said it already, and they are explaining it in easier words. So Imam said, this shukr is fi mawdi' al-jaza. Yes, so the first thing for any help you receive from anybody, the akhlaq, the manners, say what? Say thank you. Some people feel shy to say thank you, at home especially. Say thank you to your wife. Say thank you to your husband. Say thank you to your brother. Say it. Say thank you. Your mom, your dad, your children. If your child does something good, say thank you. Thank you, my son. But they feel shy to say thank you. Why should I say thank you? Because I deserve to receive this. If I say thank you, it means that they have done favor to me. It's not favor. So say thank you. This is first. This is fi mawdi' al-jaza, because when he done something good to you, you also have to do it immediately. Something immediately. Immediately, without any delay, you do good with him. But you cannot do. For example, you needed $100. $1,000. Who needs $100 today? Let's say $1,000. $1,000. He gave you $1,000. Immediately you have to return this favor. How can you immediately return? Because you needed $100, $1,000. Now he gave you $1,000. Should you give him back $1,000 in favor? To return his favor? No. So fi mawq al-jaza, look, this is what Imam is saying so beautifully. He says, when you want, immediately you have to return this favor. Immediately. How to do it? Fi mawq al-jaza, you say thank you. You say shukr, thank you. This thank you, this is an immediate return to the favor of somebody that he has given you. Is this enough? Did I return all this? I said thank you. Give me this money, thank you. And bye bye. This how I should say? No. وَكَافَأْتُ. Now the practical aspect of the thanks. This is the verbal one, which is very important. Why? Because you had to do it immediately, right away. The practical aspect is وَكَافَأْتَهُ عَلَىٰ فَضْلِ الْإِبْتِدَاءِ. Now, you should return his favor based on what he has done, as he initiated the favor with you. He started the favor. He is the one who started the favor. You are the one who is returning the favor. So even hal jaza'ul ihsani illa al-ihsan, when you try to return a favor to somebody, this difference will remain forever. Don't think that you will be paying off all his dues. No, you cannot. This is what Islam says. Some people say, oh my God, look, Islam. There are some points in which Islam has so much exaggeration. Astaghfirullah. Some people said that. Where? About the parents. Okay, the parents gave us some favor. In some societies, you know, yeah, parents are respected, of course, in all societies. But in some societies, okay, dad, what did you do for me? What did you do for me in the life? He says, I spent this much money for you. I made you, you know, study. I paid your bills. Okay, how much? Give me this. This is the check, and everything is over. You spend this much money on me, $100,000. This is a check of $100,000, and don't mention it again. So did this son pay the same amount, or let's say double of the amount, or ten times, tenfold of the amount to his father? Did he pay all his dues? It became jazaul ihsan? Islam says no. But the calculations say yes. And as I said, Islam is based on calculations. Islam is logic. So logically, you should accept that yes, a son who is giving his father a check of $100,000 or $1 million, let's say $1 million, for $100,000 that his father spent on him, he's paying him more than what it should be. Islam says, no, you did not pay anything yet. Still, you are indebted to him. But how? So this is what Imam is saying here. Look, the word the Imam used, this book, this discourse that we are discussing for a few years, so great. Believe me, every time I think that I am going to move to next subject, but I feel that I left something. So comprehensive. So Imam says, وَكَافَأْتَهُ عَلَى فَضْلِ الْإِبْتِدَاء. When you said thank you, yes, it was jaza, it was compensation. Compensation for repayment of what he has done to you. Yes, good. Then also, you do the same amount of goodness to him. It is also jazaul ihsan. Fine. It is jaza. But still, you did not pay the whole thing. Why? Because he has a fadl on you. He has done something more. That whatever you do, you cannot do what he has done. Look, the philosophy. You cannot do in whole your life, you're speaking about $1 million, if you give him $1 billion. You cannot pay off the dues. Still, you have to feel indebted to him. But why? Yeah, why is this here? That when you're giving him favor, you have to calculate everything. You're calculating only $100,000? Don't calculate only dollars. Calculate at least one thing that you cannot pay anyone in your life, whatever you do. It is al-ibtida. A start of the favor. He started the favor. You are returning the favor. So whatever you do, you cannot start a favor unless you start another favor and it becomes another deal. But for this first one, he has fadl on you. He has precedence on you. He has importance on you. You cannot pay him off ever. Why? Because it was ibtida. So whatever you do, you cannot bring ibtida. You cannot start. You cannot bring the start of the favor in that particular deal, in that particular issue that he helped you. فَكَافَأْتُ. So if I cannot do so, what I should do? أَرْصَدْتَ لَهُ الْمُكَافَأَ. Keep waiting to a time that you also should start a favor with him. Start a favor to him. Not just returning. Returning is not enough. Start a new favor for him. Keep in this. That's why we see when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the reward to someone in abundance, we say, why Allah is giving this person this much? Or about our parents, why Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam says, when somebody came to him and said, Mawla, I am in the service of my mother and my mother is sick and I spend all my time there. I do everything for her. He gave a long list of services that he provides to his mother while she was sick and said, did I pay her ihsan, her favor? Did I pay off? Imam said, if you stand in her service, remain in her service, to the highest number you think in your mind, even if it is equal to the drops of water, of rain, or the particle of sand in the desert, you cannot return one night of favor of her when she kept you, when she was pregnant with you. One night out of those 9 months. He said, how? But why? Imam said, because when she was serving you, she had your life in her mind. And when you are serving her, you have her death in your mind. So the difference between your service and her service is the difference between death and life. So how can you pay her death? You cannot pay her death. And that's why we say, and unfortunately, those who don't understand the Quran, they don't understand those things. Hal jazaa al ihsan illa al ihsan. If someone initiates ihsan, starts a goodness, starts a favor, there is no way to return his favor. Why? Because you can return whatever he has done, but you cannot return the start, because he initiated the goodness. That's why what we say to all Muslims, you can return the favor of anybody, but no Muslim and the whole nation together, no one can return the favor of Abu Talib alayhi salam. Why? Because he started. It is his favor on Islam and Muslims and Rasulullah. He started the favor. So now in return, even Rasulullah want to give him in return, whatever he want to give, it is a return. It is not a start. So Abu Talib initiated ihsan. He started the ihsan and goodness and favor for Muslims. Now how can you return how can you pay off his dues? So all Muslims and the entire Islam will remain indebted to Abu Talib alayhi salam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the knowledge and in-depth understanding of Quran and sayings of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam. And may Allah give us tawfiq to implement what we learn from Quran and the teachings of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam. Inna ahsan al-hadith wa ablaghal ma'adha kitab Allah a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim wal 'asr innal insana lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu wa 'amilus salihati wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bis sabr. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا أبي القاسم محمد. وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين من الآن إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فقد قال الله في كتابه الكريم تعليما لكم وتشريفا لصفيه: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا أبي القاسم محمد. وعلى أمير المؤمنين مولانا علي بن أبي طالب. وعلى سيدة نساء العالمين فاطمة بنت رسول الله. وعلى الحسن المجتبى. والحسين الشهيد بكربلاء. وعلي بن الحسين. ومحمد بن علي. وجعفر بن محمد. وموسى بن جعفر. وعلي بن موسى. ومحمد بن علي. وعلي بن محمد. والحسن بن علي العسكري. اللهم صل على مولانا صاحب الزمان ماحي آثار البدع والطغيان هادم أبنية الشرك والنفاق حاصد فروع الغي والشقاق. اللهم عجل فرجه وسهل مخرجه واكحل ناظرنا بنظرة منا إليه واجعلنا ممن يذكر فتنفعه الذكرى. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون.